Today I am going to show you how you can use a Python library to interact with Instagram and get a specific user data in your terminal, in your Python shell, or you can say a command prompt or assembly. I'm using Mac, so I will be coding this terminal. Today we are going to use Python to interact with Instagram while using Instaloader library. This is a library of Python. Someone has created this library to interact with Telegram, and this is free, absolutely free. You can use it free to get a user profile, user bio, user follower count, following count, and many more. All those things which are in Instagram profile, you can get that in your terminal. So I'm going to start coding for this. First I will create a new project for this, as we are creating a new project which will get Instagram users data. And I will come here to project. Now I am creating a new project. I will name this insta project. I will name, you can name it anything, and I will give it this. So I have created a new project. Now I am going to create a virtual environment. Why I'm creating a virtual environment, this is because when I install libraries of Python for my project, so those libraries will not be installed in my whole, in my root directories, in my Mac. If you are using a Windows, so all those libraries will not be installed in your root directories. But all those libraries which are needed for you to continue with this project, so all those libraries will be installed in your virtual environment if you delete that file. So all the libraries will be gone and your computer will be clean again. So I'm going to create a virtual environment. So I will make it like Python 3. I will be writing Python 3 because I'm using Mac. If you are using Windows, so you will be using Python 3 or Python, or you can also use Py, only the Py. So it will work for you in Windows only. If you are using Mac OS, so you have to write a Python 3. I'm writing a Python 3, then minus M, and then Python 3 minus M, V-E-N-V, and E-N-V. I'm going to name it E-N-V. For now, if you don't know how to create a virtual environment for Python, you can watch my videos by clicking on the I icon on the right side, top right corner. You will get an I button. You can click on that, and you will get my tutorial on how to create env for Python Django. So I'm using Python only here. So I will be typing here Python 3 minus M V-E-N-V-E-N-V. When I hit enter, it will create for me a virtual environment. As you can see it here, env file created, and this is my virtual environment where I will be going to create my project. I will be installing my libraries in the env. So now I am activating this. I will type start env. Now my env is started, as you can see it here. If your env is started successfully, you will get the name of your env right here. So now I am going to install a library for this, which is Instaloader. So I will type pip. You can use pip3 or you can use simple pip. So I will be writing here pip install Instaloader. This is the name of the library, pip install Instaloader. If I hit enter, it will be downloading started per install library. Now my library is successfully installed, as you can see it here. So I'm going to create a new file which will be insta.py. You can name it any name you want. You can give to this file. So this is my insta file. Now I'm going to write a code for how can we interact with Instagram to get the data of a specific user by username. So I would be writing the code. First, we have to install, we have to import the Instaloader library. So I will write Instaloader. Then we have to create instance of Instaloader. So I will be writing here ig is equal to Instaloader dot Instaloader, and this is a method. So now we have to give an input field for where we can write the username of a specific user to get the data of that user in our terminal. So I'm creating a username field is equal to input. I will write here enter the username of that person. So you can get the username of a person here. Now I have to pass all the parameters to that Insta library to get the data of that user. So I'm creating another instance, which is profile. So we are getting the information of a profile. So I will write here Instaloader dot profile dot from username dot from username. And now I have to pass some parameter, which is ig dot context and the username of the person. So this is the username of the person, as we have got our username here. So I am passing this variable to as a parameter to this profile instance. Now I have to print all the details, like if I print here like just a study, so that all the thing become clear for us. This is going to be Eddie. Now I have to print the username of the profile. If we want to print the username of a profile, so we have to write like print the username of that person is going to be username of, I will say like username, here is profile dot username. Now I have to copy this line and place in here. Now if we want to print number of post uploads, now if we want to get the all those posts which are updated by this person, so we can get here like number of post updated or uploads. So we can get it here like profile dot media account. Now we have to paste that file again, which is this line again, which will create a starting for us. This is not necessary. I'm writing here for a starting so that all the things become clear and distinguish from each other in the terminal while I print all the data. So I'm writing for that only. You can skip this line if you don't want to do a starting for this thing. Now I have to print like print I'm using new keyboard, so my typing speed is slow for this thing. Now this is profile profile dot username, and is having profile dot followers. So basically we are getting here the followers of this profile. So this is it, is having those followers. Now I have to paste this line again for starting. Now I have to do friend like friend if this is an f string. You can use simple friend for this, but I'm doing it all for the starting. So here I can write profile again. I will use f string profile dot username is following profile dot followers. So I will write like profile dot followers, and I will write here people like a. Now again here I will print that line and we'll do like friend. This is going to be the user bio. So this is going to be the user bio. The bio of user is, sorry, the bio of the user is, which is profile.biography. Now if I have to download the picture and all the files of that users, like all the media, you can download also the profile picture of that user. So I will be entering my own Instagram username, so you will get my profile picture in front of you. So now I have to write like Instaloader, and this is a method, so we can download the profile picture, like download profile username profile pic only, profile pic only is equal to true. Now it will download a profile picture for me. So first I'm going to show you that how can you download a profile. Now I'm going to visit instagram.com. Sorry, I'm not showing you my screen, but this is the screen. You can see it here. This is this screen. This is the Instagram of mine. So I am going to download all the details of my own profile. This is my profile. All these things will be downloaded. All the profile pictures will be in my terminal. So I am going to keep this username. Is this is my username in my Instagram. When I load this script, it will create which is this. If I run this script, it will ask for the username. If you see it, enter the username of that person, as I have written this query here. If I enter the username, my username is Khalid D3V. This is my username. If I hit enter, it will interact with the Telegram and will show me all the details of my accounts. If you see it here, my username is HalidD3V. My number of post upload here is 18. And if you see it here, like in Chrome, which is 18. If you see my followers, it is 7,964. And the same it here. I have Khalid is following. This is incorrect. Sorry, how this is not correct. But you can correct this like followees. If I run the script again and enter the username HalidD3V, it is going to show me now the correct following, which is 133. And you can see it here like in the Chrome, which is 133. This is my bio. This is my bio link of my Upwork account. And all these are my posts, which you can download in the file. Like I have downloaded it here. This library will download a profile picture. Like if I click on this, it will show me this. This is my profile picture, which is downloaded. Also, this profile picture will be downloaded in a new created directory here. The directory of the name will be the username you enter here. You will get the user account ID. This is my ID of the Instagram account. Also, this is the JSON data saved in a file. Like if you show all the data here, this same data will be saved in this json.xz file. Also, you can download the profile picture of that user. So that's all. You can try this library and also comment down if you get any issue while creating a virtual environment or installing this library. I will be here to help you. Also, don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel. Thank you.